All right, this is ELT 131 Lab 3, and I want to make sure everybody understands how this is going to work in case I am not right here. So this is an unregulated power supply right here. What will happen is that as we put a load on it, it will not maintain its voltage that you had preset. So what we're going to do is that we're going to hook it up, okay, positive lead to your multimeter right here, okay, up to your multimeter right here. Make sure your multimeter is on DC volts, and we're going to start with the 50 volt scale. And the reason why we're going to start with the 50 volt scale is because of this thing's up to 30 amps or 30 volts here. That's half an amp or 500 milliamps. When it comes to it, that's a maximum current that it can supply. That is going to be one of your answers for your lab. All right, so if I use the 50 volt scale, then over here, if you notice that it says DC volts, and don't worry about the milliamps because we don't have a current on this, it says 0.50. Well, that's the scale that we're going to use. But instead of being 0.5, we're now going to be looking at it as being 50. So whatever the value is here, it's going to be 30, 40, 50, 20, 10, 15, 12, all right? We're going to go turn this on, and for the scale, we're going to go drop it down, make sure it's zero, all right? What I'm going to do now is that I'm going to go ahead and plug this in. Okay, so now plugged in, and you notice that it's already on, somebody left it on. And I'm going to raise it up to about, I'm going to go to 20 volts here, just to kind of show. Now, this says 20 volts, but what we really should be looking at is this here, all right? So I'm going to adjust the power supply so it reads 20 volts. Right about there, all right? Again, remember, make sure it looks straight on, and there it shows 0.2, or in this case, 20 volts, all right? All right, so that's where we're going to be adjusting. Now, when I want to know maximum voltage, I'm going to turn it all the way up till it just stops. We don't want to go any further. Now, if I come back and look at this, if you look at that, it's right about 45 volts on maximum on this guy here. I'm going to adjust it for minimum, which is turning it all the way back down. Now, it's not turning it off, just all the way down until just about where it's to turn off. I'm going to come over here and notice that the scale has moved down. I'm going to move my scaling down. As we can see what happens to the needle, it starts moving up. I'm on the 5 volt scale now. I'm now on a 1.5 volt scale. I could use a 1.5 volt scale now. Here's 1.5 very easily. That's about 100 millivolts. 100 millivolts. Or I can go down a little bit further. And here's a 500 milliamp scale, which means that this would be 1 to 1. The 0.5. So let's go there. And at 0.5, with that being a 500 milliamp scale, I come all the way back down over here, and it shows I'm less than that. There's 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, almost 0.9, or 0.09, excuse me, 0.09, or 90 milliamps. Okay, so that would be 90 millivolts, excuse me, once again, 90 millivolts. Okay, so that would be my lowest scale. I'm going to bring this back up. That would be my two answers I need for there. Bring it back up to 50, because now I'm going to set this to that 20 volts, just like this. Bring it all the way up. Okay, my 20 volts. So I've adjusted this for 20 volts, and what I'm going to do is I'm not going to touch this again. I'm not going to touch it again. I'm just going to reach over here and unplug it. Okay, so now the setting is set at 20 volts according to what we have over here. I am now going to take this 100 ohm resistor, okay, it's a 10 watt, and I'm going to use it in this circuit. Excuse me, I'm going to set it down. I'm going to attach the negatively to one side, just like that. Okay, just like that. I'm going to take the positive lead and move to the other side. So we'll actually go across that resistor. Like that. Like that. And now, the power supply, which is set at the 20 volts that we had over there, I'm going to plug it back in. As you see, it goes in here and it's going to go through this resistor. There's the leads all kind of connected together. If you want to use a springboard, you could use a springboard for your primary connection. That'd be just fine. Goes through, back around, and we're going to measure that voltage now and watch what happens. I'm going to go ahead and just plug this back in and watch what happens to the voltage. Now, it's showing about, look at that, 14 volts. 14 volts in comparison. So I'm on that 50 volt scale, 0.5, which is now 50, pulled all the way down here. There's 15. That's about 14 volts, right? 14 volts. Now that gives us what we call the percent of regulation. And what we're going to do is we're going to take the voltage of full load minus the voltage of no load minus the voltage of full load. In this case, it was 20 minus 14. Okay. And we're going to divide that by the voltage of the full load. And that's going to give us the percent of regulation. And that will multiply by 100, and we'll actually see that how well this regulates. And as you can see, it's not really good. It's going to be about 70%, maybe about 60%. All right, so we're going to multiply it by 100 to get that. What you're going to do at that point, just go ahead and unplug this. Turn this all the way off. And with everything with this power supply is now done, you can go ahead and remove it. Then we're going to do the next one, which will probably be the IP27, which is this one right here.